I built a custom-sized wooden door out of 2x4s for my shed, joined together with floating tenons. And the top half of the door is going to have a window in it.
Next step is to clad the outside of the door with sheet metal, something like this. Now I'm going to fold this cut edge over with my improvised bending break. Now I got both sides cut and folded, and they overhang the edge of the door like this with a nice round edge. Now I just need to mark where the window goes. I figured I might as well also fold over the edges near the window using my break again.
This partially folded piece is going to go above the window.
Got my edges all cut and bent, and I went a little overboard because to cover this edge here, I made this part here that fits in here and covers the ends of those corrugations. And then for the top, the sheet was too short, so I bent this piece here that will cover the top of the window and also hold it in place.
But before I go any further, I have to take all this off again, mount the hinges in the doorknob, and test fit it in the shed.
That's one messy hole, and I need a little bit more room for these springs up here. Let's see if that works. Cutting that circle bigger actually does work, but it leaves an awful edge. Fortunately, this whole mess gets covered up.
Then adding some styrofoam insulation and glass in the door. This complicated piece fits under the window, and it's designed to deflect water that runs down the window over the corrugations on the front of the door. I need a whole lot of screws along the edge because the flange overhangs, and when the door closes, it slams against that flange. And one extra little tab to hold in the bottom edge of the window.
This door is suddenly not so light anymore. This Z flashing slopes down so the water comes down to here, but then it's got a lip on the front so that the water has to come off either edge instead of running down the front of the door. But all that is actually a little bit redundant because this is very close to the eaves, so I don't expect too much rain to hit the wall right here. This lip sticking over the door frame is actually what closes it against the sheet metal, but I screwed up with too much overhang on the left side here because that ends up hitting the wall. This would have been fine as long as the door pivot is left of the end of the flashing, and then it would just open like that. But my hinge is right here, and so when it opens, that flashing ends up hitting the wall. Which is why I bent it back a little bit, just to allow that door to open a little bit further.